Because in olden days when they want to name the bhavas, our rishis have taken, that time family life only. For any person in this world, for animals as well as humans, the lap of mother is more comfortable. There is no other comfortable place in a life to feel excepting the lap of mother, isn't it? That is why the lap of mother is so comfortable. Therefore, the comforts giving Rasi, the number of house, fourth house, is made as Matrubhava. It is not that mother is there. All comforts in your life are depending upon the race coming from your fourth house in your chart. So scientific for our life, division of life areas is so scientific. Myself physically, myself resources around me, my ability to do the things, my comforts and my means, fourth house. Then fifth house is what? My own thoughts, the things coming from me, created by me only. Putra bhava, son, daughter, where from they come? From me only. Therefore, fifth bhava represents the putra bhava, putras also. All our thoughts, creativity, imagination, creativity, all these things are fifth bhava. Your ability to be creative, your ability to think much in a different way, all these things are due to the rays coming from fifth bhava, fifth house in your chart. Sixth is challenges you face in the life. Unless we face the challenge, we can't do anything in the life. Even getting up and going also is a challenge. Our rishis have gone up to that extent. See, up to 1 to 4, our rishi said they are physical things in the life. And 5 to 8 are situations in the life. Life is physical, existence, then situations, then actions. These three only will become make the life. So these three are given in 4 rasis. So the fifth is thoughts, mental situation. Sixth is challenges to be faced. Seventh, where I face the challenges? In front of me, world in front of me, no? So world in front of me is seventh house, seventh vow. So interpersonal relationships are measured from seventh bhava in my life. See how they have orderly arranged. Physical situations. Eighth bhava, what is it? In spite of this, when I do something in my life, I don't know what will happen. The result is not known. Therefore, uncertainties are in eighth bhava. So if in my life, whatever I am doing, in that, any uncertainty is there, either for good or bad, that uncertainty is flowing from eighth bhava, eighth house. The race of eighth house. Situations in the life. And when a man who is born can die, nobody knows. Uncertain. Therefore, it is called Ayurbhava. See, Bhava Chakra's arrangement, you see. How much science they have used, how much methodical they were, rishis were, to define a life and to keep it, fix it in zodiac. Eighth Bhava is uncertain, Ayurbhava. Then ninth Bhava, it's for me the support in the world. Who will give me the support? Right from my childhood, my father gives. Therefore, father is there. So, Pitru Bhava, they say. Ninth Bhava is Pitru Bhava, the house for father. Not only father, the Purva Punya, whatever I have done earlier, Karma Siddhanta we follow. So, whatever Punya is there, that Punya comes to me through that ninth house only. The position, the status of ninth house in my life, in my natal chart, will decide how much support I will be getting either from the world or from the father or from anybody in this world. Support and satisfaction. Some people, if they do little thing only, they will be very satisfied. That means what? Their ninth house is full. Very easily they will get satisfied. Those who are doing some work, they will never get satisfied. Why? Because their ninth house is weak. A native whose ninth house is weak, he will never get satisfied for all the things whatever you do, whatever he does. So the ninth house is support, satisfaction, purva janma punya. These are all life related things only. Life is distributed this way. Areas of life. What is Bhava Chakra? Bhava Chakra is areas of life. Then 10th house. I have the resources. I have all the things. Thoughts. Challenges I am facing. World is there. Uncertainty is there. Support is there. But all this for what? I should do something, no? And the doing things are 10th house. Karma Bhava. Rajya Bhava, they say. Why Rajya Bhava? Because for my life, I am the king. All my actions are my own kingdom. Therefore, it is called Rajya Bhava. 10th house. In the earth circle, east part is Lagna. 10th house is on the head, overhead. 4th house is down below. That is mothers. That is comforts. And 7th house is the world opposite to me. So 1, 4, 7, 10. These are the kendras, cardinal points of the life. This is what given in the astrology. So 10th house is what? The actions what I do. For my earning, for my living, during my life. So the profession is seen there. Astrologer will tell you how your profession will be based on the position of 10th house in your chart. Karakatvas of 10th house. Karakatvas of planets relating to 10th house. Don't you see the most technical approach to the scientific approach to the interpretation of the lights? That is 10th house, Rajya Bhava, Karma Bhava. Profession is seen there for a man's life, for a native's life. Then when you do all these things, you will get something, no? Some reward you will get. So whatever you get in your life is 11th bhava, labha. So, labha in Sanskrit means labdhi, the thing which you get. It is not the gain, profit, no. Profit is not labha. Labha Sanskrit means what? The thing which you get. It may be good or bad. It may be profit, it may be loss. But whatever you get is labha. Incurring loss also is labha. Only thing, it will discomfort you. That is the only difference. You won't feel happy with that, getting that. So, Labhasthana, 11th house, is what? It is the storage through which you will be getting whatever in your life you are getting, destined to get. Suppose I am participating in a competition. I am writing an exam. 6th house is active because I have to face the challenge. Then 11th house also should be good so that I will get the success. If 11th house is weak, the rays coming from 11th house are weak, I will get fail. I faced the competition, but I may get fail. That is 11th house. So 9th house is support, 10th house is what you do, 11th house is what you get while doing this. For getting anything, when you are doing, you have to lose also something. Now, you are watching me through our sakalapujalu.com. You are getting some knowledge. You are watching is 10th house. You are getting knowledge is 11th house. But to watch and gain this knowledge, you are sparing your time. You have stopped going anywhere, you are only watching. You have lost something, no? You have lost. You have lost what? You have invested your time, your other works. You have postponed other work. Is it not? So that thing which you have foregone, the foregoing things, whatever you forego, is 12th house. See the arrangement? That means in my life, in your life, whatever you lose, lose means what? Not loss. Whatever you spend for getting something is 12th house. You want to get cured with for your any disease. How we will get cured? Unless we go to hospital. So the hospitalization is 12th house. If somebody is getting some disease or some illness, that is caused by 6th house. Challenge. Health is a challenge. So the challenge is 6th house. So 6th house generated you diseased. The disease. Illness. Now, whether I will get cured or not, we don't know. But you will have to spend money for getting cured. That is 12th house. So this way our rishis have designed the Bhava Chakra. Very comprehensive. We cannot imagine this type of arrangement, scientific arrangement in the 12 boxes, 12 houses. First of all, if we ask you, what is life? You will simply say, taking birth, then growing up, doing education, going for education, then doing a job, then getting married, having children, then being at comfortable at home. That's not life. Life is, this is only process of life. The life is every day we undergo these 12 bhavas. That is Bhava Chakra special. Because every moment we are getting the influence of the lights. So our life is, every moment is under the influence of the celestial objects. And every moment we have our 12 houses of our life every day. All the 12 houses can be attributed to each and every transaction of our life in a daily life.